Hello and welcome to this session. I'm Raghav and in this session we are going to learn all about XML namespace. Do not worry if you have no prior knowledge on this topic. I will go very basic step by step and we will start from scratch. So let's get started. Let us see this example. We have a XML where we have a table element and inside the table element we have three more elements and with the information it is giving us, it looks like we are talking about a furniture table here. If you look at this another XML, here again we have a table element and then we have elements like tr, td, which is for rows and columns, and it looks like here we are talking about a HTML table. Now this is all fine if these two tables, if these two XMLs are used separately and they are not associated with each other in any ways. However, if we happen to combine these two XMLs together, there will be a conflict because of the common table element. And to resolve this conflict, we can use a prefix in our elements. For example, if I talk about the furniture table here, I can add a prefix, and here you can see we have added a prefix called F for all the elements here. And now for the HTML table, we can do something similar. Here we have added a prefix H in front of all the elements. And now these two elements are different and they can be used together, and then there will be no conflict because we are using different names. Now, until now, we have just talked about prefixes that will help us to resolve the conflicts when we have common elements. We need to understand about the XMLNS or XML namespace attribute. Whenever we are using prefixes in our XML, a namespace for the prefix must be defined, and here is the syntax. We say XMLNS colon whatever the prefix we have used equals to a URI. For example, if we happen to combine our earlier two XMLs together, I will create a root element and then here we have our first XML that talks about a HTML table, and here we have a prefix H already added to all the elements, and here I will say XMLNS colon H, which is the prefix, equals to a URI. So this is how we can declare a namespace, and the namespace can be declared and defined in the starting of the element or the starting of the XML in the root element itself, and then all the child elements for that particular tag or element will be associated with the same namespace. And here you can see the other XML. Here again I can define a XML namespace attribute like this, and I will give the prefix here, and this is how I can define it. And we can also define or declare all the namespaces in the root element itself so that we do not have to define the XML namespace or declare them every time in the rest of the XML. Here is how we do that. You can see I have defined both the XML namespaces in the root element itself, and now I do not need to declare them again in the XML. Let me show you an example. I will go to Google and search for sample web service so that I can show you some XML, and I'm going to this calculator web service here. And here if I go to this service description, which will be a XML document, you can see here all the namespaces are declared in the starting in the root element itself, and then in the rest of the XML I do not need to declare them again. I can directly use the prefixes, and this is how we can use a XML namespace. Now we need to understand about default namespaces. Now if you define a default namespace for an element, all the child elements will be associated with that namespace, and it will save us from using prefixes in all the child elements. And this is how we do it. We say XMLNS equals to a namespace URI, and here you can see an example. Here I have added the XML namespace attribute, and all the child elements will be now associated with this XML namespace, and I do not need to add the prefixes for all the elements. And this is another example. Let me show you here. This is our XML document, and this is actually a WSDL, which is Web Services Description Language, and this is what we use in SOAP APIs. Now do not worry about that, I have a separate video to explain what is WSDL, but just for parsing this document, this XML document, I can use an extension on my Chrome browser. So if I go to the web store and apps on my Chrome, I can use an extension called Whistler, and this is used to parse a WSDL document, and this is the extension. I have already added it, and here it is. This will parse the XML document. So I will click this, and it shows me all the services in this XML. I can click on any of the service, and it shows me the XML of that API service or that request. And here you can see, this is how we can define a XML namespace, and all the child elements will be associated with this particular namespace. Now in case any of the child elements needs to be associated with a different namespace, you can also do like this. So here the add element belongs to this namespace, and all its child elements will now be associated with this particular namespace. So this is how you can define default namespaces. Now Wikipedia says that XML namespaces are used for providing uniquely named elements and attributes in an XML document. And I hope now you understand this. We have learned this in a very simple way. I hope all this was useful. You can go and share your knowledge with everyone. Also, let me know how did you like this video, and I will meet you in the next session. Thank you for watching.